In this video, I'm sharing with you how I create a hand-lettered piece in Procreate. Recently, I purchased a new brush pack for Procreate, but this one's a little different than normal brush packs. It's called the Letter and Grid Builder Pack, and it's created by Stefan Kuntz and Ian Bernard. I'll leave a link down below if you're curious to check it out. But basically, the brushes are different grids that help you create letters and build typographic compositions. Now, this is the first time I am using this product, so you'll notice that I struggle a little bit with how to use it. First, you start with the grid builder and you choose the shape that you want to house your letters in. To make it simple, since this is the first time that I'm using these brush packs, I'm just using a regular block. One thing to note when you're using these brushes is you'll probably want to decrease the size of the brush because when you tap onto your canvas, they're usually far too large and therefore cropped by the canvas size. So I had to play around with this a bit to get it to be the right size. But you can use the move tool to move the grid around and increase the size, but you wouldn't want to create really small grids and size them all the way up to your canvas because this is a raster program, so the pixels will look blurry and pixelated. So try to create the grids the size that you want and then just make minor adjustments with the move tool. I ended up creating one letter grid, sizing it to my block grid, and then duplicating that layer for each other letter in my word. I found it easier to do it this way just so that I could have more precision and control between the spacing of each letter. On a separate layer in white, I started to outline my letters. After you create a line, if you hold down, Procreate will auto-create a straight line. So I continued doing this for each letter and then dragging the swatch into the shape to fill it. Now this only works if the shape is closed, so make sure that you close your shape, otherwise it will fill the entire canvas. To bring my letters closer together, I would use the lasso tool to draw around the letter and then use the move tool to nudge them closer together. Essentially, this is manual kerning, which is something you can do when you are working with type in programs like Illustrator or InDesign. Once I had my first word done, since my second one also has four letters, I duplicated the letter grid layer and then dragged it down to start drawing the letters for my second word. These letter grids are meant to be a guide, so you can follow them as exact or loosely as you'd like. Since this is a hand-lettered piece, I'm okay with a little bit of imperfection, but you can go in with the eraser tool anytime you want to refine some of the edges. Anytime you're repeating a letter, to save time, copy and paste it. In this case, for the O, I use the lasso tool to draw over the O and then use the copy paste option and then use the move tool to move it down next to my other letter. Just make sure that you're selecting and copying the correct layer. I usually like to condense some of my layers. So for example, I want the first word to be one layer and the second word to be another layer. You can continue to still use the lasso and move tool to move some of the letters together even though they're on one layer. Once I was satisfied with the spacing between all of my letters, I selected the first word and then scaled it up so that it would meet edge to edge with the second word. And then comes the fun part, which is adding color and textures to give it more of an organic, vintage, retro kind of feel. Aside from this letter and grid builder brush pack, a lot of the other brushes I use are from Retro Supply, especially the ones that create textures. This first one is a 10% rough left halftone line texture that I used in yellow. Then I went in with another halftone brush with black to add a little bit more dimension to the sides of the letters. To add a little bit more color on a separate layer, I used yellow with a newsprint grain brush to add more color but in texture form for the background of the letters. The way that I'm building these layers is I create a separate one on top of the letters and use a clipping mask so that it only goes over the letters. Next, I'm using an ink abrasion brush in black to add a darker texture to the letters. To create texture to the entire canvas, I create another layer and move this one to the top. I change the swatch color to white and use a subtle noise brush to create an overall texture to the entire canvas. You really only need to tap a few times because this is such a large brush. Next, I duplicated the lettering layer and offset it a little bit to create a shadow. I dragged the yellow swatch onto each of the letters to change the color. Recently, I learned that when you have the move tool selected, if you just tap on the canvas, it will move it over just one pixel, which is helpful when you want really small micro adjustments. On another layer that's on top of all of the other ones, I'm going to add more texture using the Edge and Fold Brush Pack by Retro Supply. This is just to help add some finishing touches like folded edges, paper cracks, and so forth. My intention with this design was to make it look like a vintage album cover. With a lot of these brushes, you really have to play around, sometimes undo an action and redo it, because you need to be precise with where you tap and where the edge fold or crease will show up. And usually what I do is I adjust the opacity on this layer, because if I leave it at 100%, the fold marks usually are too obvious and stand out too much, so I adjust it to allow it to blend in more. If you tend to add a lot of texture to your work, I would suggest putting it on separate layers. This way you have more control, and if there's something that you want to undo, but all of your texture is on one layer, well then it's really hard to undo that. So to help you design non-destructively, try to separate different types of textures on different layers, and then you can always adjust opacity levels and go in with the eraser tool to make adjustments. Now for the final Procreate time lapse. So you can see how the entire artwork was created, starting with the letter and grid builder tools, to sketching out the type, adding halftone textures to the letters, and adding additional textures to the entire canvas to give it an overall cohesive look and feel. By the way, this is the title of one of my favorite 90s country songs by Brooks and Dunn. If you enjoyed this, found it helpful, or learned something new, give it a like and subscribe for more. I'll leave a link down below to some more Procreate-related videos if that's something you're interested in.